Hey, what is up? What is going on, everybody? Joe here, 690 ADV. You know what? Middle weight or middle ranged adventure bikes, we're starting to get options. We're starting to get a lot of options. And there's one more that's coming. And I tell you what, I don't know if you've heard about it, but we're going to talk about it tonight. Stick around. Pretty cool. And I hope that they hit one specific thing. Stick around.
What's happening, everybody? Happy Friday. Last week was a complete and utter, everything I touched was bad. I couldn't get the video to render. God, it was so frustrating. I am so sorry. Thank you for everybody that tuned into the live. I appreciate you. I can't tell you how cool everybody is. And hopefully this week we'll get this off without any problems whatsoever. The first thing, thank you again to everybody. And don't forget, hit the subscribe button. Give us a thumbs up. Do that real quick. Make it pretty fast. Don't forget, if you need anything, 690ADV@gmail.com. You can email anytime. We get lots of emails. I do my best to answer. And I know we've got quite a few people that want decals. I am working on it to get those out. COVID has made things a little bit of a pain. On to the video, stick around, and don't forget, any comments, put them down below, because I love to read them, you know, unless it's just some guy that's trolling, I just delete you anyway, so, middleweight adventure bikes are really starting to catch on, and, literally, they are kind of just popping up with all manufacturers, and this one in particular, I'm very interested about, because it's pretty good and pretty credible. We're going to have some pictures on screen, but they're just spy photos, so we don't know 100% what it's truly going to look like until it's actually released. Now, if you haven't heard of this manufacturer, if you're a new rider or if you're just getting into the dual sport or the adventure riding type stuff, there's a bunch of bikes that are out there. You know, you got the KTMs, you've got the Suzuki, you've got BMW, and the list goes on and on and on. But Aprilia, or Aprilia, however you want to say it, tomato, tomato. The Aprilia is an Italian manufacturer that really makes some nice bikes, okay? And they don't really cut a whole lot of corners. They usually build very top-notch motorcycles, and they've got a new bike that has been spied and has been rumored, and it looks to be factual that this bike is coming. And I'm excited. I cannot wait. It looks super, super cool. And the bike I am talking about on screen right now, the Touring 660 Adventure. And that bike looks really fantastic. Now I know that it's in its kind of, their spied photo stage. It's in there through the testing, just like KTM and all the other manufacturers, Yamaha, all that type of stuff. They go completely unbranded and go test those bikes out. But it's built around the bike that's coming out real soon. I think it's in October, is the RS660. And that RS660, it really looks pretty cool. It's a sport bike, so it's not really an adventure bike. But the nice thing is some of these adventure bikes get built around other motorcycles, which is, it just makes a lot of sense for the manufacturer. They can kind of double down, especially on the motors. Now, that motorcycle itself, just to let you know, 100 horsepower. That is a ton of horsepower, and I'm going to get to it in just a little bit. Like I said on the intro, the one thing I'm hoping happens and comes to be true, but 100 horsepower. Now, in an adventure bike, they are not going to probably, with a 660, basically go full bore, because that is for the street version. They're probably going to basically tune it down, and they're going to get that bike and get that torque setting to where it's going to have nice ranges of torque, because it's going to be set up for off-road. And I'm pretty sure that this bike is going to be like the T7 or the Tenere 700, they're going to work to get that bike to where it's really 50-50 street and dirt. Now, it's going to, it's Aprilia, Aprilla, whatever you want to call it. It's going to come with all the beeps and whistles. You know, it's going to come with probably switchable ABS, large TFT display, you know, all the little knicky-knacks, Bluetooth, the whole nine yards. From the spy photos, it looks like that bike is going to have a 21-inch front and more than likely an 18-inch rear. Muy bueno. That's exactly the what I would like to see on that bike, and I hope that that comes true. Now, the biggest feature of all, and I don't want to sit there and spend a whole lot of time on a spy photoed video, but you can only get so much in so quick, but the street version of the RS660 weighs 373 pounds. 373. Let me tell you something. If you don't know much about adventure bikes, 300 and anything sub 400 is a miracle. It's just a miracle. And I am absolutely getting excited because if they can get an adventure bike sub 400, they have probably done what nobody else has done. And I don't know what the fuel range is going to be, but if they can keep it around 400 and maybe a little bit under, wow. I'm telling you right now, I think that will be the biggest selling feature for a lot of riders is getting that bike at that weight. Now, it's probably not coming in 2020. It's definitely probably not coming in 2021. The rumor is 2022 for this bike, and it's not going to be cheap. Aprilia is not known for cheap motorcycles, but they do build really nice and fantastic bikes. So, a new adventure bike, nice horsepower, good torque, light. That's the key word, light. If they could get all that, man, they hit a home run. I don't know what it'll cost, but it's probably not going to be real cheap. But I tell you what, my eyes are open on this bike because I tell you what, a 660 with maybe, say, 85 horsepower and it's light, man, my eyes are open. Hey, thanks so much. Don't forget, hit that subscribe button. Hit those comments down below. Don't forget, give us a thumbs up. Be part of the channel. Because I'm telling you right now, we need you. It'd be just absolutely fantastic. You guys have a fantastic weekend. Thanks for stopping in. And you know what? We'll see you next Friday, like always. Joe, 690 out.